Heya. So I'm going to be doing a walkthrough of the Anima Frontier extension. And this extension is designed to make you a more efficient web developer by generating code using your existing code components and your code conventions. So let's begin. So I'm sharing my code base on the screen here. And this is a really run-of-the-mill React project that uses Shadcn for components, Tailwind for styles, and TypeScript as well. So let's kind of see what the extension can do. So I'm going to open it up. And you're going to see that we have three sections, a section that gives us information about our components, one that allows us to change some preferences, and then finally a way to link our Figma designs with our code base. So in the components section, you can see that we have external components, and this is a list of the third-party components that we're using within our application. So we open up or expand the bar section. This is a component that we're importing from Recharts, which is a charting library, and we get some useful information about the props it takes and also where we're using it in the code base. So we can jump straight to a usage. And this is really useful for a developer who's unfamiliar with a code base, as it helps them kind of orientate themselves around the different components. And we get a similar set of functionality for the local components too. Again, you can see the where the component exists and you can jump straight over to it. You can then again see the props and the usages. And what is particularly useful is that it helps you when it comes to refactoring your code base. So we have this user nav component over here, and we have actually two of them. They're both named the same things, but if we look over here, you can see that this one's used in the components directory and this one's used in the dashboard directory. And if we open up this component, we can see that they look quite similar. They both use the drop-down menu component. So in my eyes, this looks like a really good candidate for consolidating two components into one. There's also this preferences section that I'm going to touch on a little bit later in the video. So let's go ahead and link our Figma design to our code base. So we're in our Figma design now, and I built a couple of screens using the Shadcn design system. And we have this music screen, a forms page, and we've got a bunch of components that we're using throughout these designs. So I'm going to go ahead and copy a link to this screen and jump back to our code. And I'm going to go ahead and paste the Figma design here, and we're going to import the designs and then analyze them. So you can see that the extension has opened up this little right-hand side panel over here. And this gives us a lot of useful information about our Figma designs and also used for generating code. And so you can see that we have this tree structure that mimics what we have in the Figma design. And on top of that, we have a preview of the Figma design so that we don't need to jump between multiple platforms. Finally, you can see that we have a code generated for this particular screen, this music screen. And what's most interesting is that you can see that the components that we're using are actually the components from our code base. So you can see that we have this navigation menu item. If I jump back over here and search for it, navigation menu item, you can see that it is a very real component. So how has Frontier done this? Well, when you link your design, the extension will analyze your design, analyze the components in your design, and then analyze your code base, and it determines which components in your designs correspond with the components in your code base. So if we jump back over to the code that's been generated, you can see that in addition to using our own code components, it also uses the same tools that we're using in our code base. So for instance, we're using Tailwind for styles, and we're also writing our files in TypeScript. So you can see here in actually one of our components that's authored in our code base, you can see here we've got Tailwind classes, and up here you can see usernav.tsx. So when we opened up the extension for the first time, it actually analyzed our code base to determine which conventions are being used. So you can see it chose React, TypeScript, and Tailwind. But if I go ahead and override those, so we're using CSS and JavaScript instead, back on the right, you can see it is generating some code again. And after a minute or so, you'll see that the code will be using a JavaScript file, and it'll also be defining the styles inside of this style CSS file. So let's just go ahead and revert that. And the last thing I'm going to show now is how Frontier handles assets. So if you jump over to the menu over here in our design, and we just zoom in a little bit, you can see that there are little icons on the left-hand side here. Well, a lot of projects use assets, and so we have this handy little asset tabs that allow you to view the assets inside of VS Code and also download them directly to your code base. So I hope this tour has shown you how the Frontier extension can help speed up your developer workflow. In the next few videos, we're going to put this into action by taking some updated designs, generating some code in Frontier, and then using that code inside of our code base. Stay tuned.